Hi friends, welcome back to Feed with Colors. For those of you who are new to my channel, please hit that red subscribe button below this video and join the family. And for those of you who have been subscribed to my channel, I love you all. Thank you so much. With that being said, let's just start with today's video. Today's video is going to be about something new that I discovered really recently, and that is going to be Elle Colors Truly Matte Long Wearing High Pigment Foundation. So this is the foundation you guys that I'm going to review and do the first impression on, and I have with me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 foundation. That's 6 different shades of this foundation, and this foundation retails for $6. That is what was something that really intrigued me, and I wanted to see whether for $6 with this foundation really work, will this live up to the claims that it has. And on the website, I bought it from LAColors.com, not LA Girl Pro. This one is LA Colors, so be careful. And this one comes in 14 different shades. I see that on the website, and I felt that 14 shades is a bit too less. They need to come up with more colors, because I'll tell you guys a little bit later in this video. So I have 6 colors with me. Okay, did I tell you that this foundation is good for $6? So yeah, $6 for 1.35 ounces. So 40 ml products. This is a bit more than the regular foundations that you get, and just for $6. You guys will hear me say $6 a lot in this video. I'm sorry about it, but that is one of the things that really hit me, that I'm getting a foundation for $6. So anyway, moving on. I have 6 different shades from this, because I wasn't sure which foundation shade will match me. So I have it in 8. I have 357, 358, 359, 61, and 52. So these are the shades that I have with me. And here are the swatches on my wrist. Let me just move a little bit and show you that it's gorgeous. So these are all the 6 colors that I have swatched for you guys on my wrist. And I tried blending on buttons this foundation on my wrist with 2 different products, 2 different tools, one side with a beauty blender and this side with a brush. So let's just quickly jump into that clip to see how this foundation blended and everything is, and then I'll tell you guys more about this foundation. So let's just go. Okay, so I have already moisturized my face, and I'm going to take Cafe on the back of my hand. Just this much. Hope you guys can see it. And on this side of my face, I'm going to apply it with a beauty blender on. I'm not putting any primer because I want to see how this foundation will work on its own. So let's first see the consistency. It's a very thick, it's a very thick foundation. It's not moving anywhere. So okay, let me dot it all over my face. And so I have almost used 3/4 of the pump, and I've applied it in the form of dot on my face. And let's just start blending it with the beauty blender. This foundation smells a bit funky, and not too prominent though. The smell is not too prominent, but yeah, it has a very funky smell. So half of my face is done, and I feel that the foundation is really matching me. Should I go a little bit lighter by adding golden beige? Let's see. I'll just take a very small half pump of it, and I'll take it on my UV blender and I'll see if I can make the foundation a little bit lighter. And we can also see if this product can be layered. Okay, so this side of my face, the foundation blended really well with the beauty blender, and on this side of my face I'll use this brush, foundation brush, and I'll see, and let's just see how this foundation works with the my hair. Where is this coming from? Okay, so let's just see how this foundation works with the brush. I'll do the same thing. I'll take one pump of cafe and just half a pump of golden beige. So I'm taking it onto the brush and let's just apply it. Same thing, I'm doing a little bit of the lighter color, buffing it into my skin. Okay, so the foundation blended very well onto my the foundation blended really well with the beauty blender or the brush. Anything worked really well. I don't see any difference between the two, between the application with any of these two tools. And this foundation dries pretty matte, so it is truly matte. It is truly matte and covers really well and looks like my skin. It doesn't look like I have caked up two layers of foundation. So the coverage, I'll say, will be medium to heavy, buildable coverage. So that's a good thing actually, and I have oily skin, so this is drying, this is completely matte and it's looking very natural on the camera and in real life too. So now that I've applied my makeup, the foundation application is done on both sides with both the tools, and I'll just do the rest of my makeup and I'll come back to now. I've already told you about the price, I've already told you about where I bought it from, then I have shown you the packaging, right? Yeah. Okay, so this is how the foundation comes. It's a plastic bottle and it comes with a cap. The brand is in the video. It says truly matte, long wearing, high pigment foundation. There's 1.35 kilograms of product, which is 40 ml product, more than your regular foundations. And then the shade name is written over here, the ingredients are written over here on the back, and then it comes with a pump for $6. So the pump is really nice. That's the packaging of this bottle. That's the packaging of this foundation. Let's just see what claims this foundation makes. So on the website, in the description, I see that it's a long, what they are saying. So in the description it says, the long wearing high pigment formula applies as a liquid and blends to a beautiful matte powder like finish. Available in 14 different shades to complement a wide range of skin tones. Okay, so let's talk about the claims. Long wearing, I'll do a wear test. I'm wearing this foundation right now and I'll do a wear test of this. I will keep wearing this foundation throughout the day and we'll see how this foundation does and how this foundation performs on my skin. I have a combination, not foundation actually, I have an oily skin and I did not apply any primer under this foundation, just to see how it does on its own. And I haven't even applied any setting powder on my face for now, and you can see the finish of it is very natural. It sets, so it says that it sets to a beautiful matte powder-like finish, and I agree to it. It does set as a powder-like finish and it's very matte. And beautiful. It looks like my skin but more beautiful. So that's there. And let's just see a few cheat over here. So I have listed a few points which I look for in my foundation. So I'll just read them and I'll tell you guys whether how this foundation goes on good particular points. So blendable, you guys saw that it blended like a dream. It was very easy to blend, and I don't think I have to say anything more about it. You guys just saw it. Finish, it does settle. It is a matte finish foundation. It sets like a powder like finish, so that's true. That's very true about the claims that this foundation makes. So finish is there. Buildable, you guys saw me apply 2 layers of the foundation and it doesn't look heavy or cakey. And so it is buildable. And coverage wise, this foundation, I would say it was a medium to high coverage foundation. It covered really well and it layered really well. Then did other products sit nicely on top of it? I say yes. I have my blush, I have my contour powder going on, I did my under eyes, and I did my under eye concealer and setting powder over here. So that went really well and blended nicely with the foundation. All the products are sitting really well on this foundation, so that's a good thing. Then comes the wear test. So I haven't applied any powder, and I'll wear this foundation throughout the day today, and I'll do a little bit of I'll do a few check-ins with you guys to show you guys how this foundation is doing on my skin throughout the day. And for now, this foundation looks like my skin but better, and I'm really liking it. It's not settling into any of my fine lines. Like my skin, so I'm really happy about it. So I'll see you guys in a bit. Right now it is, apply this foundation at around 11 a.m. this morning, and I'm already wearing this foundation for last 1.5 hours. So you can see this foundation after 1.5 hour, it looks really well. It looks same as I applied it, same as how it looked when I applied it. So that's a good thing. I'll come back after a few hours to show you guys how this foundation is different. So right now it is 4:15 p.m. and this is how the foundation is looking. I have you guys pretty up close and personal to my face, and you guys can see my pores are, my T-zone is oily for sure, but it's nothing as oily as other foundation. Even my Makeup Forever or my MAC foundation also becomes very oily, and my pores become very large by at around 5 hours or 6 hours of time. So this foundation is looking pretty bomb right now as well. It is 8:15 p.m. and that's how much foundation.